In this video, let's see one numerical problem based on the concept of principal value branch. We already have learned and understood from the table what are the principal value branches of sine inverse, cos inverse, cosecant inverse, cotangent inverse, tan inverse and secant inverse. This question is what? Let's see how to solve it. Let's understand. Let's read the question together. The question says, find the principal value branch of two parts, sine inverse 1 by 2 and sine inverse minus 1 by 2. Let's see the first part, sine inverse 1 by 2. These are very basic questions, basic numerical problems to understand the same. I know that sine of what angle gives me 1 by 2? And that thing should be kept in mind, that my angle that I am referring to should lie in the principal value branch. Now, what is the principal value branch of sine inverse x? I should know it already from the table. It is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. So, no compromise. The value has to lie in this value, right? So, sine inverse 1 by 2. What angle of sine gives me 1 by 2? I know that sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2. What is sine 30 degrees? Sine 30 degrees is pi by 6. So, my theta or my angle is nothing but pi by 6. And that is my very simple answer. Because pi by 6 is what? Pi by 6 is 30 degrees. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. And that 30 degrees or pi by 6 lies in the interval of minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. What about the second part? The second part is sine inverse minus 1 by 2. Now, sine inverse minus 1 by 2 means what? It means that my value or my answer should be something, that angle whose sine is minus 1 by 2. So, what angle has its sine as minus 1 by 2? It is minus pi by 6. Does minus pi by 6 lie in the principal value branch? Yes, it does. So, the answer to this theta is minus pi by 6. And why only minus pi by 6 and no changes in it? Because I know that my minus pi by 6 lies in the principal value minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 of sine inverse x. So, the first answer of sine inverse 1 by 2 is pi by 6. And the second answer of sine inverse minus 1 by 2 is minus pi by 6. In this video, we saw one numerical problem based on the principal value branch of sine inverse x. I had taken one positive and one negative value, one numerical, to show and make you understand both the things. That if a negative angle is given, what should be the criteria to understand it? And if a positive value is given, what is the criteria to solve it? In the next video, we see a numerical problem based on the principal value branch of cos inverse x.